الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي أنعم علينا بسيدنا محمد. الحمد لله الذي أرسل إلينا سيدنا محمد. الحمد لله الذي هدانا بسيدنا محمد. الحمد لله الذي رحمنا بسيدنا محمد. الحمد لله الذي أرسل لنا سيدنا محمد. الحمد لله الذي بعث فينا رؤوفا رحيما سيدنا محمد. الحمد لله الذي بعث فينا خير الكائنات محمد. والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعمن اتبع سيدنا محمد. يقول الله جل وعلا بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى، ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى، ووجدك ضالا فهدى، ووجدك عائلا فأغنى، فأما اليتيم فلا تنهر فلا تقهر، وأما السائل فلا تنهر، وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. سورة الضحى is among the سور in the Quran that have very special atmospheres. The entire atmosphere of سورة الضحى is moving and it comes in a very tough circumstances. Of course, the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is all filled with hardship, is all filled with challenges. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says about himself, مَا أُوذِيَ النَّبِيُّ مِثْلَ مَا أُوذِيَ. Nobody of the Prophets was hurt, and people did transgressions and things against him like that happened to me. حتى أن الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الذين يؤذون رسول الله، those who hurt رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The people before الصادق الأمين، anything they want they go to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The minute he told them I am asking you to believe in لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله، أبو لهب his own uncle start walking behind him. Everywhere he goes and does the prayer, Abu Lahab says he is my nephew and he is lying. The people of Quraysh, of course, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Mecca. And Mecca at that time is the trade center, the business center, the agriculture, but the educational center. People who went in the Arabic linguistics and all this, they challenged themselves where? In Mecca. Said all these poetries, all these things. The kuffar of Quraysh, they were waiting for an opportunity to put the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam down, any way, any shape, any form. And when they couldn't find anything, they would make up things. But of course, they want something solid or concrete so they can attack the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa taala, there is lutf ajeeb, and lutf rabbani. This care of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being khayru khalq Allah, the best of the creation, sayyidul kainat salawatullahi wa sallam alayhi wa alayhi, had this care from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accompanying him everywhere he was. No doubt. That's what the kuffar of Quraysh couldn't see. Therefore, even his own talk, they want to wait till he makes a mistake when he talks. Allah says, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنُوا إِلَّا وَحْيَ يُوحَى. Then they want to say, let's see if he, his morals, Allah says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعْلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You have the highest, the best, the greatest of morals. Before he announced himself, or he started giving the da'wah, he was ordered to give the announcement of the da'wah, and after as well. The people of Quraysh, they wanted something that they can do to break this, what they thought is impossible perfection. This perfection was created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what they couldn't see. Allah reveals wa-duha wa-layl. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before we go into the ayah, let's go to Asbab al-Nuzul a little bit, and I'm going to just mention a couple. First, Imam al-Razi rahimahullah in tafsir says some of the Yahud wa Nasara, or Yahud specifically, they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, and they asked him three questions. At that time, since in talk, in speech, they couldn't find any problems. In morals, he was the highest of morals. And this gives us a lesson, dear brothers and sisters. Al-Mustafa, Al-Habib al-Mustafa, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, had the highest of morals and practiced them along with those people who hit him, with those people who hurt him, with those people who not only didn't believe in him, but they tried to kill him. Maybe that's a lesson that we should kind of learn. Because nowadays we apply good morals and good dealing with only those we like. And those we don't like, whether they're Muslims or not, it doesn't matter. We're going to hurt them. Subhanallah. Look at the al-Uswa al-Muhammadiyya of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So people, how do they want to do that? They'll come and ask. They try to ask impossible questions. You know how some people always, they come to you and they have something impossible they want to ask you. And either they know the answer, but they want to test your knowledge. You see these people, subhanAllah. But that's not how it's supposed to be. Why are you asking? To show other people that he knows. To show other people that he has an understanding. Or yeah. Like some person came to one of the Sahaba, radiallahu anhum, and he said, you claim that you are Sahabi, you're very knowledgeable. He said, yeah. He said, well, tell me, who shaved the head of Adam alayhi salam when he made Hajj the first time on earth? It has to be a barber. Jibreel? So, Jibreel shaved. Then he said, how can he answer? Next question, how many hairs do I have in my beard? That's what he's asking him. He said, you have many hairs, every single one of them is cursing you. There's one out there. So you have people that come and ask these kinds of questions. Those people always want to come and challenge the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and ask him all these things. Not wal munafiqeen, wal kuffar, wal mushrikeen, and those who are semi. So Razi says, well, they came and asked him about three things. And ar-ruh, wa ashab al-kahf, wa dil-qarnin. Because it's written in the old books. So they will see this man, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is not lettered per se, he did not go to university and learn how to write and read and write. So there's no way for him to have read all these things. He's been always with around Arabic tribes. So let's get him. Open up the deep subjects of the book, of the old books, and ask him. That's one narration. Of course, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was supported with al-wahid all the time. The other question, no, Muslim al-Bukhari narrated in the Sahih, that people came and asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the wahi was delayed. Why was the wahi delayed? There are many wisdoms, many hikmah for that. Sometimes, especially at the beginning, the environment was not ready for the rule, for the Sharia rule. For example, al-khamr. At the beginning, you tell people, don't drink. What do you mean, don't drink? Some people don't. So, sometimes the ruling of the Sharia, the jurisprudence, al-ahkam al-fiqhiyya wa al-shar'iyya, comes gradual. Sometimes the hukm should not appear right away, at the beginning of the state of da'wah. البيت الكعبة المشرفة في صحيح الإمام مسلم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says يا عائشة يخاطب المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها وارضاها he says oh Aisha if your people يعني the people of Mecca are not new in Islam their deen is very thin still I would have rebuilt the Kaaba the way it was when Ibrahim عليه السلام built it but he didn't do it why because people are still So there is sometimes reason for the delay of the hukm or of the sentence or of the ruling and the jurisprudence. The kuffar of Quraysh, they loved it. What? No wahi? Look, huh? There's no wahi. Now he has no way to answer. He's not answering. And they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will let you know. No answer. Huh? حتى إمام مسلم ليس الصحيح والبخاري says, جاء احتبس جبريل. Jibreel alayhi salam stopped coming to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for some time. Ihtabas Jibreel al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam faja'at imra'atun min Quraysh. This is in Muslim. A woman came from Quraysh. What did she say? Abqa'a alayhi shaytana. His shaytan. Look at this. Because now they can't fight him. So what do they say about the half shaytan? His shaytan is slow. He's not coming to see him all the time like he does. Because before, every time they ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam something, he gives it to them, and it comes true as the sun in the middle of the day. So what's the explanation in their opinion? Shaytan. So the shaytan that was coming to him, she's telling the people of Quraysh, stop coming to him. Who is this one, this woman? This woman, Hammad al-Hatab. Huh? The wife of Abu Lahab. Tabbat yada Abi Lahab wa tab. Ma agna anhu wa al-Rakazab. Sayasla nabat then, wa imra'atuhu. She is the one. So she said, عليه شيطانه. His shaytan is not coming to kill him. You ask him questions, he cannot respond. Hamad Khatab, her name is Umm Jamil. Her name is Umm Jamil, the wife of Abu Lahab, the sister of Abu Sufyan. Umm Jamil bint Harb, the sister of Abu Sufyan bint Harb. Well, The hadith continues to say, when the people of Quraysh were saying these things, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَالضُحَى وَالْلَيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا خَلَى It means, وَالضُحَى, Allah is swearing by الضُحَى, وَالْلَيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى And the night, when the night becomes still, مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا خَلَى وَدَّعَك means, to say goodbye or to abandon. وَقَلَى means hated or distance. So Allah is swearing by الضُحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى يَا مُحَمَّدْ We have not distanced you and we are not away from you. Indeed, we are supporting you. Allah swears وَالضُحَى وَاللَّيْلِ Why did Allah say وَالضُحَى وَاللَّيْلِ Let's stop just a little bit here. وَالضُحَى وَاللَّيْلِ الضحى والليل. الليل not only any ليل. والليل إذا سجى. سجى means سكن. سكن means still. The last portion of the night. The last portion of the night when the night becomes still. When the souls become closer to those to He. When the souls become closer to those to He who created them. When the people who are doing tasbih and doing qiyam. This pure night. Still, إِذَا سَجَى And then after that pure portion of the night comes that pure fajr. وَالضُحَى So it's like this continuation of first you'll have that night and then وَالضُحَى comes and shines very purely. Allah is swearing by الضُحَى وَاللَّيْلِ that, Oh Muhammad, don't be sad by those people who are saying all these things because you are supported by us and You are like a walking ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as beautiful and as pure as وَالضُحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى Beautiful picture and beautiful continuation. Huh? Also, some of us said وَالضُحَى because الضُحَى is what? الضُحَى is the time when the magicians, remember with Fir'aun when we talked about Musa? Fir'aun got all the magicians down. To challenge Musa alayhi salam. So when Musa alayhi salam threw the stick, This is a creation of Allah. This is not magic.
So the magicians, they realized that this is what Musa came with. It's not magic, really.
It really is a miracle that Allah gave him.
So as-sahara did what? The magicians do what? Did what? They all made sujood to Allah. And that was in duha. وَأَنْ يُحْشَرَ النَّاسُ duha.
Allah says.
So Allah says, وَالضُحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى مَا وَدَّعَكَ. Allah did not abandon you. وَمَا قَلَى and did not distance you, ya Muhammad. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرُ وَلَّحَمَّدُ.
They're giving you all these hardships, all these times. فَلَا يَحْزُنْكَ قَوْلُهُمْ. Don't be sad for what they say.
Everything they wanted to say, they said. People went so low that they even talked about his honor. What can hurt him?
As far as da'wah, as far as logic, as far as proofs, as far as all these things, they couldn't get through.
So what do the ignorant, wal-fasiqeen, wal-jahala, wal-munafiqeen, wal-mushrikeen do when these things happen?
They take, look, they go distance themselves, and they call, they give labels to others. This is the terrorism, really. They want, why? They don't want people to listen.
Therefore, Abu Lahab used to go always behind the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, making sure that don't listen to him.
Don't listen to him. I'm very close to him. He's my, I'm his uncle.
Don't listen to him.
That's the big weapon.
Allah says, مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرًا لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. الْآخِرَةُ, Allah is trying to tell us here, الْآخِرَةُ is much better than this first, this dunya. Because Allah is telling, when He says, وَلَلْآخِرَةُ, the Akhirah is better for you than the dunya. The Akhirah is where everything is. The Akhirah is the end result. The dunya is just a channel. You're going through this road that would lead you to the Akhirah. So therefore, since the Akhirah is everlasting and the dunya is not, your heart always should be attached to the Akhirah. You should work towards the Akhirah, because the Akhirah is better for you. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this Akhirah, أيها الحبيب. This talk is from الحبيب to his محبوب sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who loves Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's talking to his محبوب on this level. You know, this surah, this entire surah, is a surah of love and comforting. Comforting for all these wounds, all these tricks, all these hearsays, all these rumors, all these fabrications, all these forgeries that Quraysh unleashed on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah has given him this surah like al-duha wal-layl, as pure as that, so he can be comforted. Don't worry.
These things will go.
وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. Sayyidina Ali, كرم الله وجهه, was asked one time. He said, the man was asked, he said, how are you, ya Ali ibn Abi Talib? How are you today? Sayyidina Ali looked at him and he said, كَيْفَ حَالُ مَنْ يَفْنَى بِبَقَائِهِ وَيَسْقُمُ بِصِحَّتِهِ. How would be someone who is gonna perish by his staying? The more you stay, the closer you'll get to your end.
Look at this. كيف حال من يفنى ببقائه.
بقاء means staying. And as the more you stay, the closer you get to your end. So how would you be? ويسقم بصحته. That the more صحة, the more health you have, the closer to disease you are. The longer that health lasts with you, the older you get, then the closer to weakness and disease you are. So how would you be? How would you be? كيف حال من يفنى ببقائه؟ البقاء ثاني، كل من عليها فان. ويبقى وجه ربك ذي الجلال والإكرام.
Everything is gonna finish.
So how are you telling me, how am I living in this life? Threatened every second. Where's that comfort?
Also, what we can take, وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. What can we take also from it? We can take that al-akhirah
should be the place that we work for. Therefore, our heart should be attached to the Akhirah. And once the hearts are attached to the Akhirah, the dunya is worthless. It totally becomes worthless to you. It's time passing. Ask someone who is 20 years old. How long has it been? You know, how is Earth? Yesterday I was fine. Today I'm 20. Take this same question, ask someone who's 40. How is it? It's like yesterday I was 5, today I'm 40. Ask someone who's 60. How old do you think? It's like 5, today I'm 40, 60 years old. Someone who's 80, same thing. It seems like they all have the same answer. Ajib. SubhanAllah. They all have the same, they tell you the same thing. It's like yesterday, it's like a dream. Maybe it is a dream. So time passing by, therefore Allah is telling us through His beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa al-akhiratu khayrun laka, for you too, for me, al-akhirah khayr laka min al-ula. Don't hold to the ula, because the ula is going to go. Because if it was permanent, if it was lasting for anybody else, we wouldn't have gotten it. We wouldn't have been born. We're not the first cycle to come and go. We are, Allah knows how many cycles before us. People came and died and came and died and came and died. وَلَا الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. Because in the Akhirah, what else? فِيهَا مَا لَا عِنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. In the Akhirah, if you have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us successful, then in the Akhirah there are things that the eye has not seen and the ear has not heard and what can never a human being imagine. What can you imagine? Try to imagine, you know, what would Jannah be? Like all these palaces and...
You want to have pool in your home? You also have pool, inshallah, you know. What do you want? Jacuzzi? You also have jacuzzi.
Rivers, palm trees, you want grapes, you want apples. What do you want? What can you imagine? That's still not enough. فِيهَا مَا لَا عِنُ رَأَتْ. An eye has never seen. An ear has never heard. No matter what you imagine, Allah has prepared for you better than that. Yani there are many narrations that the least one that comes out of now.
You know that one that comes out of, the last one that comes out of Jahannam. Nasallahu alayhi wa sallam.
The last one that comes out of Jahannam, what, how does he do it? Some narrations say that he comes out crawling. And he, the fire of Jahannam takes him back. Falls back in Jahannam, wa'iyadu billah. And then he keeps trying until he crawls and barely he passes the line. And then say from Jahannam, he tells Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his heart, oh Allah, I don't want anything more than this. This is it. There's no, that's it. Huh? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the narration say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him, well, you have paid your dues. You have purified yourself. You have to be pure before you go to Jannah. You have to be, because if you want to be among the Sadiqeen, والشهداء والصالحين والنبيين والصحابة الكرام, you have to be among them. You have to be purified. تنحيص. So sometimes, may Allah does not give us that torture in the Akhirah, but sometimes it happens that way. Allah, in the narrations, some narrations say that Allah tells him, in this Jannah, you will have, now you've exited now, you can have more than the greatest king of earth had. What did the greatest king of earth had on his time? Biggest palaces, all these things. You can have more than that. More than that. The man thinks, you know, I just want to get away from Jahannam. I don't really care about. I just don't. What do you mean? The more than what the biggest sultan on earth had? I don't deserve anything like that. He's saying in his heart. And then until the narration said, Allah would tell him that you have 10 times more than the biggest king on earth had. Go. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives Allah al-Ghani. Ya ayyuha al-Nas, antum al-fuqara ila Allah. Wallahu al-Ghani al-Hamid. So, فِيهَا مَا لَا عِنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنْ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطْرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. Because the maqam of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be seen and very visible to all those who believe in him and those who don't believe in him in the day of judgment. So the Akhirah, Allah is telling what I have prepared for you, Ya Habibi, Ya Rasulullah, fil Akhirah, is much, much higher than it is in the dunya. It says the narration, the Razi, Imam Razi says in his narration that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also was very hurt by Jibreel not coming to him. Jibreel used to come to him all the time, tells him. Now Jibreel, when Jibreel left him for some time alayhi salam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was kind of hurt. Where is Jibreel? People are coming and asking me all these things. Until Ar-Razi says, when Jibreel came with this ayah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبَّكَ وَرَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى. He says, Ya Jibreel, you came. I have been missing you. Ya Habibi, Ya Jibreel. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells him, Jibreel alayhi sallam tells him, Ya Rasulullah, Wallah, I am more in missing of you than you are of me. Yani, I am more missing you, but we do not descend until only by the will of Allah, by the order of Allah. وَمَنْ نَزَلِنَّ بِأَمْرَ رَبِّهِ بِأَمْرَ اللَّهِ. If Allah tells me to come, I will come. But if it was up to me, I would always be serving you, صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. The point of dunya is al-akhirah. الدنيا الشيخ عبد القادر جيلاني رحمه الله رضي عنه, what does he say? الدنيا مزرعة الآخرة. The dunya is the farm of the آخرة. You plant the farm, you plant the seeds today, so you can get some in the آخرة. وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى. نعم ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. When some of the Sahaba or Tabi'een were asked, what is the best surah and what is the best ayah in the Quran? They said this ayah, وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى, which means Allah will give you, the akhirah is better for you than the ula, and Allah will give you until you are pleased, Ya Muhammad, Ya Rasulullah. Imam Muslim narrates in the Sahih, pay attention to this hadith, the Sahih. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when Ibrahim, when Isa alayhi wa sallam said, تُعَذِّبُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُ. Isa on the back of Isa alayhi wa sallam, Allah says, oh Allah, if you want to punish them, they are your servants, they are your creation. In other words, it's a nice way of saying, they're yours. If you want to punish them, it is your will. But if you also want to be merciful, فَمَنْ أَطَاعَنِي مِنْهُمْ وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَإِنَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And then Ibrahim says, whoever follows me, obeys me, then you will guide him. And whoever disobeys me, oh Allah, you are Ghafoor Rahim. And the Prophet ﷺ is remembering these positions of these Anbiya alayhi wa sallam. And in the hadith, Imam Qutbi says that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started crying. And he went and he lifted up his hands to the skies and he says, oh Allah, ummati, ummati. Oh Allah, my ummah. Ibrahim is making dua for his ummah, Isa is making dua for his ummah. Oh Allah, ummati, ummati. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam weeps or a tear comes out of his honorable eyes, al-malaika kullah tadaj, al-malaika goes, what's going on? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the malaika, tells Ya Jibreel, go and ask Habibi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is wrong, why is he crying? And Allah is all knowing. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells him, and Allah tells them, Jibreel, go back, Ya Jibreel, go back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and tell him, Allah will please you. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Allah will give you until you are pleased. And Imam al-Qurtubi narrates, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِذَنْ وَاللَّهُ oh Wallah, I will not be pleased, and one of my ummah is in Jahannam. Ra'ufa Rahima, when we say Ra'ufa Rahima, meaning practical touch with the meaning of Ra'uf Rahim. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ وَفِي الْوَايَةِ مِنْ أَنْفَسِكُمْ. أَنْفَسِكُمْ in the other narration means the best of you. مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ from amongst you. From the best of us, صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. What is he going to give him? What do you want? If you get all that, then how about the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? After all these hardships, there's a test, a dunya imtihan is a test. You pass through the test, and Allah then gives you. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Until you are pleased. Until you are pleased. Look at this promise. and then Allah takes it to start to give us some أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى. Weren't you yatim? And Allah, yatim means orphan. And one meaning, yatim means also nothing that's like him in a sense. Haven't he seen you? Weren't you yatim? Weren't you orphan? And then he gave you the support. What? How did he give him support? The Mufassirin say that he gave him support by providing for him Abu Talib, his uncle, to care for him and to protect him from everything. Therefore, as you know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his dad passed away before he was born. Who took him? Abd al-Muttalib. Jadduhu Abd al-Muttalib. Abd al-Muttalib, Sayyid Waqqa, Sayyid Makkah. He used to put the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's 5 years old, next to him, the back to the Kaaba, and he talks to the people. Huh? Well, they tell him, why did you put you're putting this kid next to you? Yeah, I know, Abu, his father died, but why are you putting next to you? Abd al-Muttalib would tell them this, he will have a great matter. Therefore, when Abd al-Muttalib died, who did he bring? Abu Talib. Ya Abu Talib, come. Usika. Usika bi Muhammad min ba'di. The only wasiya, he told them, Muhammad min ba'di. You take care of him. Abu Talib went and did everything exactly. He put his life, of course, as you all know, Abu Talib put his life on the line. Abu Talib put his sons on the line. Abu Talib put his house as the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was raised in the house of Abu Talib from the year 9 until he was married. All in the same house, eating the same place, and the wife of Abu Talib, سيدتنا فاطمة بنت أسد رضوان الله عليها, she was his mother. That's why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to call her my mother. يا أمة أنت أمي بعد أمي. You are my mother after my mother. She was like his mother. And she is the one who the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went and to her grave. One day when she died, رضي الله عنها, he went into her grave. And then he said, yeah, now you can put her. Yeah, now you can lower him to her grave. And therefore, Abu Talib, among the things that he says in the poetry, وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْتُ بِأَنَّ دِينَ مُحَمَّدٍ خَيْرِ مَنْ فَوْقِ الْبَرِيَةِ دِينَ وَاللَّهِ لَنْ يَصِلُوا إِلَيْكَ بِجَمْعِهِمْ حَتَّى أُوَسَّدَ فِي التُرَابِ دَفِينَ فَاصْطَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ. Basically, the long poetry, we don't want to take too much time. But what Abu Talib says, I know that the deen of Muhammad is the best of deen that is on earth. وَلَقَدْ دَعَوْتَنِي. And you have called me, and I know it. كُنْتَ ثَمَّ أَمِينًا. You are trustworthy, and you are honorable, and you will say the truth. وَاللَّهِ لَنْ يَصِيلُوا إِلَيْكَ بِجَمْعِهِمْ. By Allah, Abu Talib is saying, by Allah, they will never come close to you until I am dead, buried. حَتَّى وَسَدَ فِي التُرَابِ دَفِينَ. Until they put me, they bury me under the soil, they will never come close to you. يا محمد go فاصطع بما تؤمر ما عليك غضب go do تبليغ. And truly Abu Talib put all these things, even that they had to exile him and put him in that embargo, that economical embargo, we'll talk about it some other time. ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى. He gave you this environment where Abu Talib, your uncle, gave you all the support and everything you need. And Abu Talib one time saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam praying, wa Ali on his right side, and he looks at Ja'far. Ja'far is standing. He says, "Sajna bi amrik." Go and pray on the other side of your cousin. Go and take the other side. Don't make a hole there. Make sure you surround him. Alam yajidka yatiman fa'awa wa wajadaka dhallan fahada. Dhallan, and he found you dhallan fahada, and he guided you. But some people nowadays, because we've heard around, they open up the Quran and say, but that means the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was dhal, aliyyadu billah. Bun najmi idha hawa ma dhalla sahibukum wa ma ghawa. Allah swears by najmi idha hawa, your companion was never misguided. Wa ma ghawa, wa ma yantiku anil hawa in huwa illa wahyun yuha sallallahu alaihi wa alaihi. There's no way. What do you mean? الضلال, if it's against the iman, this can never be applied to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In no time, before or after the announcement of his message sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What does الضلال mean then? ما ضل صاحبكم وما غوى. Many narrations. Let me just take few because there's more than 16 opinions in that among the Mufassirin. And sometimes when you say ضل means forgot. Forgot. Huh? Yeah, Razi says when the people came to him and asked him about Dil Qarnayn wa Ruh and Ashab al-Kahf, and some narrations say he didn't say inshallah. Yeah, that's one narration he said. So he forgot to say inshallah, and therefore this dhalal means forgetting. Allah says in the Quran, أن تضل إحداهما فتذكر إحداهما الأخرى. Which means one of them forgets. When you have two witnesses, two females, get two of them, because if one forgets, أن تضل إحداهما, Allah says. يعني if one forgets, then the other one will remind them. The Quran, number two. لا. الضال ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك ضالا. Here they say it means المحبة. الضلال is محبة. How is that? Look at people when they talk about Yusuf عليه السلام. تالله إنك لفي ضلالك القديم. You talk about Yusuf? Oh, you are في ضلالك القديم. You are in your old ضلال. في محبتك القديمة ليوسف. ووجدك ضالا فهدى. And he found you filled with love for him. So he guided you to the way that you love him. سبحانه وتعالى. One or two. لا ضالا. They said وجدك ضالا فهدى. It means وجدك ضالا. The tree in the Arabic language, if the tree is in the middle of the desert, only one tree, they call it ضالا. It means single self, like something it's not supposed to be there, but it's there. Huh? And it's there because it's there in the middle of the desert. There's a tree. They call ضالا. Anyone who's going towards the road, what do they tell him? Remember, go by the tree. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you like that tree, فَهَدَى, and he guided people to you. Huh? Now others. الضلال also means being covered by an overwhelming environment of different nature. What does that mean? For example, يُقَالْ ضَلَ لَبَنُ فِي الْمَاء. If you put yogurt into water, little yogurt and more water, what happens to that yogurt? ضَل. ضَل means what? It's spread in the water, so the overwhelming majority really is water, but it's there. The yogurt is there. So the same thing, Allah from Quran says, أَإِذَا ضَلَلْنَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. If, those people who deny the Akhirah, if we are ضَلَلْنَا, it means if we were buried in the soil, will we also be resurrected بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ in a new way? And it means what? Their bodies will be disintegrated with the soil, that you cannot differentiate from the soil. And you're telling us, there people are asking, we will be resurrected again with our bodies and all this? So الضلال also could mean that. What else could it mean? الضلال also means that you were among people. وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًا فَهَدًا. الضلال means lost. You were lost. What do you mean? Was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lost in that true sense? No. Never. What does that mean? You were lost in the people that disbelieve in Allah. You are one and everybody else is disbelieving in Allah. So you are like lost among them. And therefore Allah hada, he guided the people to you so they know. That's one. Another thing they said, Al-Mufassir said, وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًا فَهَدَى. It means he found people. You are lost among people, but not lost in the sense of place. You are lost that the people did not know your qadr. People did not know your maqam. People did not know your status. So Allah guided his awliya by Islam so they realize how high your status is. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ووجدك عائلا فأغنى. We will wrap up this up in about 2 minutes. ووجدك عائلا فأغنى. عائلا means poor. And أغنى means he made you rich. But we don't have any narration that says the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was wealthy. Do you have any narration? النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم was زاهد. was always had nothing. يعني السيدة عائشة رضي الله عنها, she says in the في مسلم that 1 month and 2 months come and there is no food in the house of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Where is the wealth? How did he make you rich? He made you rich with these anwar, والأسرار والفتوحات and all these things that he opened for you and he gave for you and the logic and the proofs and the Quran and the Sunnah and فأغنى. So therefore I don't think that so you become غني that means you have more money. يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء إلى الله. No matter how rich you are, قارون was فقير إلى الله. He needs Allah. He's in need of Allah. And therefore his money did not help him. So you go towards money and then what happens at the end? فقير. الفقر is not having money. And then فقيرا عائدا فأغنى فأما اليتيم. And then because you have, يا رسول الله, you have been يتيم, you have been an orphan, you know what it's like to be an orphan, you know what it's like to suffer, you know what it's like to people call you names. فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر. اليتيم, don't oppress him. And النبي, again this is another point, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم never oppresses anybody. But it is the kind of style in the Quranic language where the Allah tells his Prophet, so you and me can hear.
And not for him صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is the perfect human being.
So you and me, أما اليتيم فلا تقهر.
You know how it was to be yatim. Give them mercy.
وأما السائل فلا تنهر. Whoever asks you, give him. Whatever you have, give him. وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. And with the ni'mah of Allah, then talk. And the best ni'mah of Allah is the ni'mah of Islam.
So you can talk about it, so you can learn it.
There are many things we can learn, inshallah, some other time. We will try to comment more on the tafsir of the ayah. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ali Ibrahim. Barik ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad كما باركت على سيدنا ابراهيم وعلى ال سيدنا ابراهيم في العالمين انك حميد مجيد. اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين واعلي يا مولانا كلمه الحق والدين. اللهم من اراد الاسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه اليه, ومن اراد بهم غير ذلك فاجعل دائره السوء عليه. اللهم رد المسلمين الى دينك ردا جميلا, اتي انفسنا تقواها وزكها انت خير من زكاها, انت وليها ربنا ومولاها. اللهم مرضانا واعف مبتلانا وفك اسرانا وارحم موتانا. اللهم لنا ولابائنا ولمشايخنا ولمن له حق علينا ولمن على الخير اعاننا وعن الشر ابعدنا ولمن اوصانا بالدعاء. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد الوالد. اقيم الصلاه.
الله اكبر. الله